Alrighty. So, on request I had snow camouflage. S-N-O-W, but we really don't get snow down here, so I'm going to try and do my best. Looked at some stuff on the internet. Got a pretty good idea what needs to be done. So, the first one, brown, the one I looked at had white, brown, black. I'm just gonna use this sucker. Alright, so, we're gonna start out with more luck stuff. Like, more like. Like that. You can see that really well. Not like this one, it's more like wavy. We're going more for like dead, like alrighty, so that's what I've drawn. You can draw more if you want to. This is just to get the point across, and when I cut that one out, I'm going to do that differently because it looks really bad over there. Alrighty, so what I did is I have made a photocopy. Right there. Pretty cool. So, I have that one, and I have that one. Pretty cool. Alright, so now I'm going to go and use the back of this as my white, because I don't have any white spray paint. And I have brown, and I'm going to be using blue instead of black, because my black's all out. Alrighty, so as you can see, I did really light brown, because you really don't want to make it too dark, because you're really trying to show that white's the dominant color. I'm going to move on to this one. Like that. And this would be black. Here. This would be like that, but that would be black. What you also can do for one is if you spray your gun with white, you can always do, if it's like, if you don't have like a lot of twigs and stuff where you are, it's from where it's just snow, you can take your other stencil, or this one. And you can sort of set it as an angle. You could do like ice or something. And you can, and you know, you can just do like little brown pieces or whatever. So yeah. And then you always can do because a lot of the snow camouflage pictures, they had white and then brown and then black. All the other ones, that they sort of just look like urban camouflage, so you could always just paint it with white, gray. And this is the other alternative if you really don't want to use a stencil. So like right here, pretend that's the gun. You can basically just go out and you can find twigs. You can just sort of, you really want to be flat against sort of your painting. So just improvise. Big old nasty one. And then what you would do is you just spray it over it. Oh yeah, you would start out with a black coat and then you would spray down with white. And then you'd get and you get something like that, and then you could always go and you could put some like leaves and stuff in there, you know, just find random junk that you would like, and then you always can just do that, and then you can go over it again with another stencil. You can make it really cool. So actually what you could start out with, let's pretend this is black. Oh, alright, white is black and then blue is white. So what you could do is you could start out with this one, your brown. Where'd my brown go? Remember, light coat of brown. You don't want it too dark, and then you can sort of you actually do some dark stripes. So you get like different effects. And you can take all your little twig things. Arrange them however you want to. And this is really, you really want to do this if you know what your surrounding is like, so you don't, you know, paint it and then it doesn't match up. You get something like that, which is pretty cool. So yeah, if you really, what you, I tried this technique a while back. Let me see if I go have. I don't have it, but what I did was I sprayed my gun with spray adhesive, and I stuck different things and stuff on it. Like I took some holly branches and you know, like stuck them on the sides, and then I spray painted over all of that. And that actually looked really good. So you had like little green holly leaves. But you really wouldn't want to do that if you're out in like an open field. Which brings me to my next stencil. I cannot find it, but it looked like grass. I wish I could find it. I have my cutting board. Oh well. So yeah. So you just have to mess around with it. You can either do, and remember when you're doing the sticks and stuff, whatever color you spray down is going to be what your background color is. So you would spray down with black, and then you could go in with your white, and then you could spray paint over all the twigs. And after that done, you can go with the brown stencil. You know, you just gotta play around with it. Like I said, I really don't use this one, so. Alrighty, so another little thing I found was just little sets of three blotches. That's how big they are. And they were just like painted like all over it. And, you know, once in a while there was like, you know, a visual one. It was like separating them. Something like that. And that's basically what it was. There's the scale again if you want to see it. And that's the other way. So, three ways to paint. Winter/snow camouflage. Hope you enjoyed it.